Allora, innanzitutto se ritiene che le istituzioni europee, infatti ha già risposto, ma non una risposta più precisa, siano riformabili anche senza arrivare alla rottura dei trattati. Secondo, sull'euro, restare dentro, andare fuori, un euro a doppia velocità, cosa ne pensa? E soprattutto sulla situazione italiana, intorno alla sua lista, che relazione, rispondo una volta, che relazione tra il gruppo intellettuale della proposta e i partiti di sinistra base con la natura?
This was three questions, three different questions. So, first of all, I believe that this is a political decision to change Europe and to save Europe for a catastrophe, to save the people of Europe for this disaster of austerity. I could say a lot of decisions that overcome the treaties the last 3 years, the years of the crisis. So I don't believe that this is a precondition to change decision, to change direction in Europe. Of course, I believe that we must have radical changes in the treaties, but this is not the issue now. The issue is to change political decisions in Europe. For example, in which treaty is written that Troika will have the responsibility to order our lives in Europe? In which institution of Europe Troika is legitimated? So I believe that we have to understand that we are in a very crucial point in a crossroad in Europe, and we have to choose direction. Either we will continue in this direction of austerity and catastrophe, either we will change Europe, we'll stop austerity and regain democracy in Europe in order to save the people of Europe of this disaster. The second question was about Europe. we don't believe that for each country and for each people there is a viable solution if to exit the Eurozone and to try to combat it with our national currency, each other, with drachmas to lireta, with lireta to escudo, with escudo to peseta. This is not the solution. Don't forget that before Euro we had our national currencies. And the neoliberal policies, they were there, also with national currencies. So the solution is to change the base of the current policies to stop austerity, to stop neoliberalism in Europe. And of course, at the same time, I believe that this is the only solution to save Eurozone and the European Union as a whole. Because I have said a lot of times that Eurozone is like a chain with 17 links. If one link will broke, the chain will be collapsed. So we have to be very careful in this case, and we have to understand that Eurozone and Europe, European Union, it is not a private organization in owner of Mrs. Merkel, but it's an organization of 70 equal members. So we have the same rights with all the others to try to demand for our rights in this organization. The third question was about the initiative in Italy for the Common List. I'm very, very happy for the positive reaction of my candidacy in Italy, and I'm very, very happy that we try and finally, I think that we managed to overcome the differences and we will create a common united list. I want to make clear a united list of the left in Italy to support my candidacy. I want to make clear that I'm not here to be a leader of a new Italian political party. This is not my intention. And I'm not here to divide. I'm here to unite. And this is the model of Syriza in Greece. And at the same time, I'm very, very happy for the positive reaction in the base of social left of Italy. This initiative created by the base of social left with the very good contribution of the intellectuals, the six intellectuals that signed the initiative. And this initiative is very, very open to everybody, not only to separate independent persons, individuals, but also to political parties, also to political social movements. And I believe that this is the message. If we will be united and strong, we will manage to have a very, very good result and to change the balances in Italy in order to change the balances in Europe.
Thank you.